Please welcome Vice President, Incident Response and Cloud Operations, Varonis, Matt Radolec.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me here today. I am so excited to be up here on the main stage. AI is the biggest opportunity and biggest threat to your organization. Gen AI has taken the world by storm, and we're all asking the same questions. How do we control AI and the data it accesses and shares? How do we ensure sensitive, personal, and regulated data isn't used for AI training or is only used when we really mean it? And how will we avoid an AI breach? In this session, you'll learn how to ensure AI doesn't expose data. I'll show you real-world examples and what to avoid as you adopt AI. Follow along closely, and you'll be able to reduce AI's blast radius and keep data safe. Hi, I'm Matt, and I'm a data protector, a role I haven't taken lightly in my 15-plus year career in cybersecurity. From protecting classified State Department data to safeguarding your organization's juiciest secrets at the prestigious law firm WilmerHale, I've always been drawn to data. Today at Varonis, nearly 7 years after joining, I lead incident response, managed detection and response, cloud, and most recently, sales engineering organizations. I also host the hit podcast, State of Cybercrime. I've always been hustling for data, and I'll never stop. Today, my job is telling you how to avoid a data breach by AI. Our world runs on data. When you look at and examine any one thing, what you see flowing through it and around it is data. Healthcare depends on data. Energy, finance, legal, manufacturing, higher education, government. Is there a single industry that doesn't depend on data? I can't think of one. Why aren't you looking at your data like you would your most precious belongings that you lock away in a vault? Why is it that during a breach, you speak in actor names, MITRE techniques, malware variants, and CVEs? Why aren't we talking about what matters most to a business? Data. Data is where the damage happens. Data is where we feel the pain of an attack. Data is where you'll feel the pain of AI. Next, I'll tell you a few examples of Varonis incident response investigations that will help you understand. Does anyone know someone who suffers from Alzheimer's? Alzheimer's is a disease of the mind where your brain can't find the missing puzzle pieces. One of the leading organizations for Alzheimer's research and resources for patients and families, who raises around $500 million a year in charitable donations to continue to fund Alzheimer's research, support, and care, chose Varonis to watch after their data. They came to this painful realization: how bad things would be if research data was stolen, or worse, corrupted by an attacker or AI. This would surely devastate the Alzheimer's community and their families. Now, I want you to stop and think about it for a second. Stolen data is one thing, but if clinical research and medical data is altered and then fed into an AI for training, this could have grave consequences. But this didn't happen. Attackers knocked at the door, they tried to break in, but they couldn't, because this organization had 24/7 eyes on their most critical asset, data. Well, what about electricity? Does anyone use electricity? Surely everyone here benefits from the lights being on and being able to hear my amplified voice through the speakers or watch this presentation on the screens. Electric is that feeling you get when your company closes a big deal or lands a new client. Late last year, we signed a major city in the Southwest, and we were so thrilled. They weren't just a municipality, but a major metropolitan area and utility provider. Everything about the city is connected to object stores and identity providers that we monitor. What sales didn't tell us, though, is that this client was under constant attack, and their environment, not quite zero trust yet. On more than five occasions so far, we've seen attackers attempt to break into various systems like water, traffic, the electrical grid, even the voting office. Each time, though, because they had eyes on their data, we squashed the attackers and the city was safe. No data was lost. None of the citizens felt the pain of an attack. This is exactly the kind of threat that all the buzz about Volt Typhoon is about. In one of those incidents, we literally kept shit from hitting the fan. Can you believe that even sewers are connected to data? That we are only one data breach away from a really bad day? Think about what would have happened if we weren't there to say, keep your hands off their shit. Look, I know this is a crap example, okay? But I'm trying to get you to see that everything is connected to data and AI is magnifying this risk. We all know an AI superstar when we see one, and Jensen Huang nailed it. AI is a data problem. Your data is your company's source code. It's intellectual property. It's worth a lot. So let's go back to why we're here. I used to come to RSA conference as an attendee, just like you. I'd go to the booths, get the swag, I'd see the demos, I'd attend the after parties and wake up with a killer hangover. I'd prioritize the keynotes, thank you for that, and the tech track sessions that fit the latest threat vectors I wanted my organization to be able to thwart. Above all, though, I remember each year having a theme, a vibe, a droid it seemed we all were looking for. This year, it's not single pane of glass, it's not ransomware or threat intelligence, it's not threat hunting, it's AI. Artificial intelligence is the buzzword and the era we are all in. How are we going to use AI for good? How are we going to stop evil AI? And how are we going to prevent our first AI data breach? AI is the storm we all have to weather. Like it or not, Pandora's box is open and the seas are choppy. But there is a light at the end of the tunnel. There is land and clear seas in sight. The promise of AI is already being recognized. Show of hands, how many of you have used AI and had even a small positive impact on your life? Did you save some time or maybe accelerate access to information? Did it provide you with some timely search assistance? By the number of hands, that's awesome. AI is already making an impact. To tell you a little bit of a story, I love animals. Fun fact, I have five pets, two dogs and three cats. And this story of how ChatGPT saved a dog's life, it really hits me in the feels. This guy took his best friend, his dog Sassy, to the vet for what looked like a tick-borne disease, something that's relatively routine to treat. After receiving treatment, though, Sassy wasn't getting any better. In fact, Sassy was getting much worse. A few days later, Sassy is looking pale, clinging for life. Her owner is desperate for help, and he turns to ChatGPT. He gave ChatGPT all the symptoms, the fever, the blood test results, and what do you think that ChatGPT said? Well, hey, look, I'm not a veterinarian, but it might be immune-mediated hemolytic anemia, or IMHA. So this guy takes his dog, Sassy, of course, to a second vet with this suspected diagnosis. He gets treatment, and they are both running around and playing Frisbee today. And here you sit. You're embarking on this quest for your organization. Stop AI from getting out of control. Stop a data breach by AI. This is our big moment in security. It's our chance to empower our businesses and our organizations. We can help them reap the rewards of AI, whether it's from saving lives, being more productive, being more profitable, or even innovating and changing the world. We can be the heroes of data, but we have to do it safely. If you really want to get this right, you need to understand probabilities, gambling, and the differences between chess and poker. Statistics say that no one in this room or watching at home can beat Magnus in a single game of chess, but many of us would win a few hands of poker against Daniel Nathaniel or Annie Duke. Why is this? Chess is a game of skill, everything comes down to a series of predictable inputs and outputs, the moves you make and the moves made by your opponents. With poker, there is an element of luck, of probability. This is why you can even win a few hands against the best in poker, but you never would in chess. When you're thinking about AI, you need to think in the same way, in terms of probabilities. What can't you control, and what can you control? Deepfakes. Deepfakes everywhere. This is not something that you can control. We won't know who will be impacted by deepfakes or when. We also can't control which inboxes will get the deepfake emails or the AI-generated phishing messages or who will be the first to join a Zoom meeting with a deepfake. What we can control, though, are things like our security policies, our acceptable use policies, our third-party agreements, our NDAs, our incident response plans, which I'm a little biased towards, I must admit, and of course, AI copilots. Copilots are happening. Companies like Google with Gemini, Salesforce Einstein, and most notably Microsoft with Copilot have opened the Pandora's box of generative AI, and your business is hungry for it. How these copilots work is when a user inputs a prompt, the copilot is going to combine your business data with the data in the large language model, or LLM. The LLM has general knowledge and a lot of things it's pulled from the internet over the years. The copilot has access to the same data that you do, even if you don't realize that you have access. So if you don't get access control right here, you will fail. You will have a data breach by AI. But if you thought figuring out things like SharePoint permissions was hard, wait till you work on your first graph connector. The graph is the access map for a copilot to business data. And graph connectors allow you to connect your M365 copilot to just about anything. When you build this connector, though, you have to explicitly set the access control list. It's not pass-through like it is for Microsoft 365. Access control is paramount, and there is nothing sophisticated about setting permissions in graph connectors. Your developers will literally set up access control lists by hand, just like what you see on the screen. I'll bet you, if you have a graph connector, your permissions are set to everyone, just like I'm showing here. Why is this? Because it's the easiest way. It's the default. This is also, though, how the Varonis incident response team found the culprit of our first breach by AI. An organization called us in to determine how a competitor got so much information from a particular database of theirs, and how that competitor was using that data to send targeted ad campaigns to their clients. A few days after our initial assessment and investigation, the evidence was clear. Like a lot of companies, access control was pretty lax. They couldn't tell what cloud databases and object stores housed critical data and which didn't. They had widely adopted copilots and their connectors. In fact, one of their employees, former employees, I might add, was the first to realize this mishap. They grabbed the database of accounts, including the products they owned and how much they spend, and they left and took it to a competitor. Everyone here is in security. We know granular access control and zero trust are the holy grail, but these types of suggestions are easy to breeze by and think, we got this. But do you really? Because with great power comes great responsibility. AI is great power. Security has great responsibility. Who's here's data is totally locked down and think they got nothing to worry about? Anybody? Okay, I got one in the front. Because let me tell you something, Varonis, Microsoft, we love assessments and sharing the results of those assessments across the galaxy. What do our assessments say? Well, they say the blast radius is huge and only going up. Data is exploding in the cloud and complexity is increasing at alarming rates. I bet you didn't know this, but the average organization has at least 17 million files open to all employees. They have 40 million plus unique access control lists to manage, and yet users are only using 1% of the permissions that they're assigned. So if you're not a pathological liar, and you didn't raise your hand moments ago, you aren't alone. Most people haven't gotten access control right because it's hard. But you're here. You came to this keynote, which I really appreciate, by the way. You're ready for change. You want to reconcile this data access crisis. You might want to make data something that you can control. To do this, though, you have to shift a considerable amount of attention away from your endpoints. Endpoints are to data like an ATM is to a bank. Sure, there's some money there. It's worth monitoring, but it's not where your crown jewels are. The crown jewels, the good, juicy, rich data, it's in your vaults. Getting security right here will pay dividends downstream and will most probably prevent your first AI data breach. So you have to monitor every transaction, whether it's from the ATM or the vault. You have to detect anomalies, and you have to police every prompt. You have to focus on the things you can control. Focus on your vaults. There are a lot of vaults to secure and police. And while Microsoft beat everyone to having an embedded GenAI experience on your computer, they aren't the only one. You'll face these challenges in every app. We've already seen it with Microsoft Copilot, Salesforce Einstein, Amazon SageMaker, and Google Gemini. I know many of you, myself included, have gotten the call from the bank or the credit card company. You're at home, and someone's at a Best Buy in Miami trying to buy a TV with your credit card. This is possible because the bank monitors every single transaction. They profile you, and they escalate to you things that look out of the norm, anomalies. You need this kind of fraud detection on your vaults, too. You need to know if a user or a co-pilot is taking data in a way that doesn't look normal. You also need to police your prompts. Think about it. Has anyone ever gotten a speeding ticket or another type of moving violation? I know I have a few. Does the fear of getting one of those stop you from driving like a maniac? You have to issue tickets and take reckless drivers off the road, even more so when people abuse their co-pilots. Because having weak access control and not policing your prompts would be akin to giving every employee a Ferrari and letting them loose to race on residential streets. It will surely end in havoc, destruction, and balls of flames of Italian mechanical perfection. Since they limit this talk to 20 minutes, there is one thing I'm not going to have time to fully explain, and I just need you to trust me on. This battle with AI will not be won if you put humans up against the robots. If you want to survive AI, you'll need your own robots on your side. Automation and AI is the only way to combat AI. Trust me. So, let's recap. The world runs on data. AI is the next storm that we all have to sail through. You can do it. You can lead the way. You are the hero in this story. Because remember, data is looking up at you and it's saying, "Help me, RSA conference attendees. You're my only hope." Thank you.